In this week's episode, we're going to explore surfboard volume and what it actually means to us. Let's start by asking the question, what is volume? The volume of your board is a measurement of the total amount of space that your board occupies. If your board were a perfect cube, then a simple length by width by height calculation would be all we'd need. However, as your board is full of curves and concaves, the whole thing is a little bit more complicated. In the past, the only way of knowing was to dunk your board in a bath and see how much water was displaced, and this is why we normally measure surfboard volume in liters rather than cubic inches. Nowadays, with most boards designed using computer software, it's easy to calculate the volume of a finished board, and most of the leading brands display the volume of their boards both on their websites and increasingly on the surfboard itself. As some ballpark figures, an average shortboard would probably be around 25 to 35 litres, while a 7-foot mid-length would be between 40 and 50 litres. A longboard might go from 60 to 100 litres, and a stand-up paddle could easily top 250 litres. So why is volume important? Volume matters because it gives us a realistic idea of how big our boards are. Ever since the retro revolution of the early 2000s, people have been riding an increasingly diverse range of surfboards. And now the standard three dimensions, length by width by thickness, don't give us enough information to decide if a board will work for us or not. And you can shape three boards with the same three dimensions that look and surf very differently. The thing that volume really tells us is how buoyant the surfboard will be, and therefore how well the board will float you in the water. This matters because the higher a board floats you out of the water, the less drag your body will create as you paddle, and so the faster you'll be able to move. The faster you can paddle, the more waves you can catch, and the less steep those waves need to be in order to catch them. However, the volume of the board is only half the equation. The other part is the weight of the surfer, as a heavier surfer will need more volume to create the same buoyancy. This brings us to the important ratio between a surfer's weight in kilograms and a surfer's volume in liters, which we've decided to describe as a percentage, as we think that's the most intuitive way to express these ratios. As an example, an 80-kilogram surfer riding on a 40-litre board would have the ratio of 50%, while a 40-kilogram surfer on the same 40-litre board would have a ratio of 100%. There are no hard and fast rules when it comes to choosing a surfboard. Many people have learnt from day one on a tiny shortboard, whilst others have purposely chosen to only surf 9-foot-plus longboards, and individuals from both groups have gone on to be world champions. There will always be a huge amount of subjectivity in the final decision, and a board that one person loves may not click with another. With all that said, you should not view any size board as a goal. You should view a maneuver as a goal. A misconception that has plagued surfing for decades is the idea that a smaller board equals a better surfer. And too many people view the size of their board as a badge of their ability in the water. The problem is that while a smaller board is, in theory, easier to turn than a bigger one, it is also easier to force bad technique on, which long term will hold you back far more than those extra 10 litres ever could. A board that is too small will paddle slow, catch waves late, and bog down in turns. A board that is too big, on the other hand, has only one downside. If your technique is poor, you can't cheat and talk the board round with your upper body. By using this information as a starting point, along with a volume to weight calculator, you will be able to choose a board to help you work on the techniques to progress. Subscribe below for more Surfing Explained, and thanks for watching.